This is a border of switchgrass and big bluestem that we planted around the entire property. So it's not a native population, but it's been here probably for 25 years or so. The reason for having the native around the property is if we get prairie dogs that try to come in from the neighbors, or if we get grasshoppers that come in from the someplace else, they end up stopping here. And that's really helped us in terms of not having to use control measures for those kind of things. So this would be closer to a native soil. This, again, we're right in the same vicinity as we were before. This is closer probably in terms of a well-developed native soil than what we've seen before. So, and again, you'll probably hear the breaking of the soil roots. The roots here will go 6 or 7 feet deep and extract moisture and bring things up. And you notice how hard this one is to get out of here. Now, the early settlers talked about grass as high as the back of a horse. And that's what these are. When I first was reading those stories when I was young, I was only familiar with things like crested wheatgrass and brome grass, which you see a little bit of that around here. And I thought they had really small horses. So. Now there we have incredible soil structure. You know, again, our biology is there. And the thing, if you ever get a chance, and the people here can do it, is to smell the soil like this, because it has a smell that's very unique to healthy soil. But these roots will go on now, go deep, bring up nutrients. If we would put it back into crop production, they would be where the water enters the soil.